Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. You know, we are dealing with the chapter fraction and we are learning operations on fraction, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division on fraction. So till now we have learned addition and subtraction of the fraction. We have seen that the rules of adding and subtracting fractions are same. Okay, we can add or subtract the fractions when their denominators are same. If denominators are not same, we have to find the LCM of the denominators, and then we have to make the denominators equal, and then we have to add. And you know, we add only numerators, not denominators. That we have seen in addition and subtraction. In today's lecture, we are going to move forward and we are going to learn the next operation, that is multiplication of fraction. How to multiply the fraction? Whether we have to multiply only numerators, or can we multiply fractions if the denominators are not same? These rules of addition and subtraction applicable here. Let's see. Remember or pay attention carefully. Keep it in mind that rules of addition and subtraction are not applicable here. To multiply two fractions, we need not denominators same. If the denominators are not same, doesn't matter here. The denominators should be same in addition and subtraction. Here, how to multiply? See, the first practice 5.13. First example is find the product of 3 and 2 upon 7. 3 and 2 upon 7, that is 3 multiplied by 2 upon 7. Find the product. Product means the answer which we get in multiplication, it is called product. Okay, so direct they have not asked multiply the following fraction. What they have asked, find the product, means we have to do here multiplication. Okay, so 3 multiplied by 2 upon 7. Now see, here 2 is numerator, 7 is denominator. Here what? There is no, only they have given 3. Then what is numerator and what is denominator? See, when any number is given, 4, 7, 8, only number, that means it has denominator 1. So only 4 means actually 4 upon 1. Only 7 means 7 upon 1. Okay. So similarly here, only 3 means it has denominator 1. Okay, so how to multiply now? See, while doing multiplication of fraction, we have to multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. That is 3 multiplied by 2 upon 1 multiplied by 7. Okay, so let's multiply this. 3 2s are 6 upon 7 1s are 7. So is it same like addition and subtraction of fraction? No. In addition and subtraction of fraction, there should be denominator same, and we add or subtract only numerators, not denominators. So multiplication and division is different from the addition and subtraction. Okay, so those rules of addition and subtraction keep separately, keep it in mind separately, and multiplication rules keep it in mind separately. Okay, 6 upon 7 is the answer. Next, 5 multiplied by 1 upon 8. Now see, 5 has denominator 1. How do we multiply? We multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. That is 5 multiplied by 1 upon 1 multiplied by 8. Okay. So 5 ones are 5, 8 ones are 8. 5 upon 8. Further, we can find the reduced term of the answer. That was same in like addition. In addition, we have done, no? The answer which we got, we found its reduced term, smallest term, by dividing both numerator and denominator by same number. Okay, that we can do here at the end. Is it possible here to find a reduced term or smallest term? 5 upon 8, are they in any same table? No, this is only the smallest term. Next, pay attention very carefully. 2 and 1 upon 9, that is 2 multiplied by 1 upon 9. So 2 has denominator 1. Multiply numerator with numerator, 2 ones are, and here 1 into 9, 1 multiplied by 9. So 2 ones are 2 and 9 ones are 9. Can we find its lowest term? Are they in any common table? Both 2 and 9? No. So this is only the final answer. Next, 2 and 3 upon 7, that is 2 multiplied by 3 upon 7. So 2 has denominator 1. Multiply numerator with numerator. 2 multiplied by 3 and 1 multiplied by 7. Okay. 3 2s are 6 upon 7 under 7. They are not in any common table, so this is only final answer. Next, 5 multiplied by 2 upon 9. That is 5 has denominator 1. Multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. So 5 2s are 10, 9 1s are 9. 10 upon 9 is the answer. Okay? So in this way we have to multiply the fractions. Right? Pause this video, write this in your notebook. After that we will see next examples. Pause this video. Okay? I am going to rough. Now see, directly I am taking example number 8, 9 and 10. Example number 6 and 7 you have to solve by yourself. Understood? I am taking example number 8, 9 and 10. See, 5 upon 8 and 2, 9 1, 1 by 2 and 1 whole 3 upon 5. This is mixed fraction. 1 by 1 whole 3 upon 7 and 1 whole 3 by 10. Okay. Now see. Again same 5 upon 8 and 2. So 5 upon 8. Find the product. So multiply by 2. So 2 is whole number. It has denominator 1. Let's multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. So 5 multiplied by 2 and 8 multiplied by 1. 5 2's are 10, correct? And 8 1's are 8. Now see here in the answer. Are both numerator and denominator in any same table? Observe carefully. Yes, they are. In which table? They are in table of 2. So let's divide both numerator and denominator by 2. 2 5s are 10, 2 4s are 8. So 5 upon 4 is the answer. Next, 1 by 2 multiplied by 1 whole 3 upon 5. Now see, this is mixed fraction, no? So first, whenever there is mixed fraction given in the operation like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, in any operation, whenever there is mixed fraction is given, the first what we have to do, convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. You know how to convert. Okay, so 1 by 2 write as it is not mixed fraction, this is mixed fraction. How to convert? Whole multiplied by denominator plus numerator, that is 1 multiplied by 5 plus 3 upon denominator 5. Okay, so 1 by 2 as it is taken down. 5 1 are 5. 5 plus 3? 8 upon 5. Okay. 5 plus 5 1 are 5 plus 3? 8 upon 5. Now multiply numerator with numerator, denominator with denominator. Okay. 1 into 8 upon 2 into 5. So 8 1s are 8. 5 2s are 10. Again, we have got 8 upon 10. Okay. Now, is there 8 and 10 in any same table? We have done here. Okay, so they are in table of 2. So, let's divide it by 2. So, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. Next. Here, both are mixed fractions. So, first we have to convert them into mixed fraction. Improper fraction. And then, we have to multiply them. Okay. 1 whole 3 upon 7 and means multiplication here, 1 whole 3 upon 10. So here while this mixed fraction, let's convert into improper fraction. 1 means whole multiply by denominator plus numerator upon denominator multiply by this fraction, let's convert into mixed improper fraction, 1 whole into 10 plus 3 upon denominator 10. Okay, so 7 1 the 7, 7 plus 3 10 upon 7 multiply by 10 1 the 10, 10 plus 3 13 upon 10 upon 10. Okay, now 10 into 13 upon 7 into 10. Okay, so see now 13 tens are 130 upon 10 sevens are 70. Now see both these 130 and 70 are in which same table? They are in table of 10. So let's divide them by 10. If you divide 130 by 10, what answer we are getting? 10 ones are 10. 3 minus 0, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 came down, 30. 10 threes are 30. So we got answer 13. 10 divided by 130, answer is 30. Upon 70 divided by 10. 10 sevens are 70. So 13 upon 7 is the answer. Okay? So in this way, we have to multiply the fractions. Remaining two examples, example number 6 and 7. Practice yourself. Understood? Observe this video, watch this video very carefully. And the example number 6 and 7, solve by yourself. Okay? So I hope you have understood the multiplication of fraction. Any doubt if you have, ask me immediately. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.